Now, first of all, what do we learn from this hadith? One thing we learn from this hadith, for example, you get Sharh Sahih Bukhari of Ibn Battal. He says, يُرِيدُ أَنَّ الْحَيَاءَ لَمْ يَزَلْ مُسْتَحْسِنًا فِي شَرَائِعِ الْأَنْبِيَاءِ الْأَوَّلِينَ. We learn from this, haya was something that's not just exclusive to the sharia of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. It was something that also was taught by the prophets before us. What is haya? Now, I found this book yesterday. It's called Sharam o Haya. It's an Urdu book by Marana Zulfikar Ahmad Naqshbandi. And I really, really enjoyed it. And most of my research is mainly from that book. The definition of haya that's given there is تَغَيُّرٌ وَانْكِسَارٌ يَعْتَرِ الْإِنسَانُ مِنْ خَوْفِ مَا يُعَابُ بِهِ. Like, for example, right? When a student does something horrible in my school, you know, I would call them. And when you talk to them about it, a lot of them would break down because they feel so guilty about what they did. Once in a while, you'll have a student and they'll just be stone-faced. They'll just be like, that student would, then I would be really worried about that student compared to the first student who kind of had a sense of shame regarding their actions. Haya is not only that guilt that happens afterwards, it's mainly the guilt that happens when you're looking at an action and then you are so ashamed of it. I mean, haya is a very encompassing term in Arabic, right? A good understanding of it, I think, is the shame you get when you are faced with such an action. When you think about it being ascribed to yourself, that'll be a flaw on yourself. It's often used with sexual modesty. It's also often used with, for example, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam in one hadith, he says that inna Allah hayy, Allah has a lot of haya, and Allah has haya when a person raises their hand in dua for Allah, in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah has haya in not giving them anything when they raise their hand in dua. So it's used in that type of shame as well. It's also used in a different type of shame where, for example, you're scared of openly doing something wrong. Do you kind of get an understanding? It's like a feeling that overcomes you when you think about wrong. So haya is a very big umbrella term, but it refers to the sense of shame that you have about wrong. What we're seeing now in our generation, haya is part of the fitrah, the prescribed human nature that most people will have unless they would kill it, like the sound human nature. It's almost cool not to have haya. You know, people like to publicize their sins. People like to, for example, dress provocatively. People like to look at provocative things. I think none of us is completely pure with our eyes. May Allah forgive us. It's just so prominent in our media and even our online surfing and all that, where, you know, immodesty is all around us. Junaid Baghdadi, he was asked about haya. So he was asked, how does one cultivate haya? And he says, Al-haya'u ru'yatul ala'i wa ru'yatul taqsir. Haya comes when you look at all the things that Allah has given you. You look all around you, you see how much Allah has given you, and then you look at how little you're doing. You look at how many shortcomings you have in the fulfillment of the ibadat. Like, imagine someone is giving you so much, right? Imagine, you know, someone's giving you like literally a mansion to live in, they're paying for your car, they're paying for everything, and then you're doing nothing for them. You'd obviously feel, you know, human beings have this sense of reciprocity where we feel like we have to pay people back. So when we start focusing on all that Allah has given us and we look at how many faults we have in terms of worshiping Him, that's where haya will come from, according to Junaid Baghdadi rahimahullah. Sayyidina Umar radiallahu anhu, he says that man qalla haya'uhu qalla wara'uhu wa man qalla wara'uhu mata qalbuhu. A person who has little haya also has little faith, and a person who has little faith, their heart is dead. A lot of us want to be more spiritual, but then, you know, we're exposing ourselves to all these sexual provocative images all the time, and we're consuming this, and that has an effect on our faith. And I think this is really, really something that to this extent was not available before. Wahab bin Munabbah, he says, al-imanu uryanun. Iman is naked, which kind of means like iman, the basic package of iman doesn't really come, like just being a believer doesn't come with a lot. Libasuhu taqwa, but you can clothe this iman with taqwa, and then you can beautify it with haya.